Hello and welcome to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. We were discussing BFS and in BFS algorithm, you can start traversal operation by choosing a starting node, then visit that starting node, and in the next step, you need to visit all the unvisited adjacent node of that node. After completing that level, you need to go to the next level. For example, if I take A as the starting node, I need to visit that first. If I take it as level 0, then in the next step, I need to visit all the connected nodes of A, B, D, F. So that is level 1. Next, we need to visit all the connected nodes of previously visited nodes, C, G, I. So this is level 2 and this is level 3. And as I said previously, we can use BFS algorithm to check whether given graph is a connected graph or a disconnected graph. And also you can use this BFS algorithm to find whether given graph is a strongly connected graph or a weakly connected graph. In the same way, you can use this BFS algorithm to find shortest path between two nodes in the unweighted graph or in weighted graph where all edges have the same weight. So BFS algorithm can be used to find the shortest path between two nodes. If I want to find path between B and F, there are many. BAF, BCDAF, or BCHGDAF, right? There are many. But shortest path is this one, BAF. This BFS algorithm helps us to find the shortest path between the two nodes. In graph, there can be more than one shortest path. That is, if I want to find the shortest path between B and D, BCD as well as BAD, both are the shortest path, right? BFS algorithm helps us to find one of the shortest path in the graph between two nodes, okay? So let's see how to find the shortest path using BFS algorithm. First is we need two nodes, that is starting node and target node. We want to find the shortest path between two nodes, right? So we need two nodes, the starting node and target node. And next is you need to traverse the graph using BFS algorithm and the operation begins from the starting node. Next, while visiting the nodes of the graph, keep track of every single node's parent node. That is, first we'll visit A. If it is the starting node, we'll visit A. After that, we'll visit B, D, F. That is the connected nodes of A, right? So the parent node of B is A, D is A, parent node of F is A. Here A is the starting node, so it doesn't have any parent node. While traversing the graph, you need to keep the track of parent node of every single node, right? Next is, once you reach the target node, while traversing the graph, you'll visit every node of the graph, right? So when you reach the target node, through its parent node, you can find the shortest path. Little bit confusing, right? So let's take an example and we'll see how it actually works. So here, I want to find the path between A and G. So A is the starting node, G is the target node here. Because A is the starting node, I'll take parent node as none and mark the starting node as visited and add it to queue. Next, remove starting node from the queue and check whether that node is the target node or not. Here, A is not our target node, so continue the BFS operation. Take all the unvisited adjacent nodes of A, find its parent node, mark those nodes as visited and add them to queue. Here, B, D, F are the unvisited adjacent node of A, so parent node is A. And mark them as visited as well as add to queue. Next step is you need to remove B, that is the first node from the queue, B, and check whether that node is our target node. No, our target node is G. B is not the target node. Then continue the traversal operation. Next, you need to take all the unvisited adjacent node of B, that is the removed node, previously removed node, and first find its parent node. Then mark them as visited and add it to queue. So here, unvisited adjacent node of B is C. So parent node is B, add it to Q. Next step is we need to remove the node from Q. Remove node is D and check whether that node is our target. No, it is not our target node. Continue the operation, BFS operation. First find all the unvisited adjacent node of D, that is G and I here, and find its parent node, that is D. Mark them as visited and add them to Q like this. Then next step, remove F or the node from the Q. The removed node is F. Check whether that node is our target node. No, it is not. So continue the BFS operation. Find all the unvisited adjacent node of F. Here none, because here you can see adjacent node of F is A, which is already visited. So none. So no need to add to Q, right? Move on to the next operation, that is remove node from the Q, that is C, and check whether that node is our target node. No. So continue the operation. Next, we need to find all the unvisited adjacent node of C, that is E and H. So find its parent node, that is C, then add them to Q. Mark it as visited. Next, remove the node from the Q, that is G. Check whether that node is our target node. Yes, here G is our target node. Then what you need to do is you need to find its parent node. Here you can see node and its parent node. So parent node of G is D, and parent node of D is A, and parent node of A is none, that is the starting node. Reverse it, A, D, G. This is the shortest path. Find the parent node of the target node, then find its parent node, then find its parent node, that is the starting node. So that is the path. In this way, we can find the shortest path between two nodes using BFS algorithm. Okay, so this is about this explanation. In the next tutorial, we'll write the program. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.